Will you continue your opposition throughout the enabling legislation?
Well, so far as I'm against on principle, I've got to carry on, haven't I, on principle.
Even though this might put the Conservative government at risk?
On my principle, yes, for my country and for my party.
I will support the government at all times in a vote of confidence in Mr. Heath and his administration, accepting only the common market and entry into the EEC, which I will oppose by every democratic and parliamentary means at my disposal.
If one of the votes which you would cast against the government put that government at risk, what then?
My answer to you, sir, is very, very short. If the government were put at risk, you are suggesting that a Labour government would take its place. My reply to you, therefore, is that a Labour government would be ephemeral. The common market would be irrevocable.
So, you would continue to vote against the government?
In those circumstances, the national interest transcends any party, political or partisan interest.
I have three priorities in my life, without being too specific about it. I have my God, my country and my party in that order. God doesn't enter into this, but my country and my party do. And I believe that to keep Britain out of Europe is in the interests of my country, and I should do my best to do that.
So that if the worst came to the worst, from your point of view, you would bring down the Conservative government?
I should have to make that unfortunate choice unless their present European policy was abandoned.
I would have no hesitation in saying that I put my duty towards what I consider to be my duty towards my country, which in this particular case is its preservation from going into, from signing the Treaty of Rome, before any feeling of duty or loyalty towards the Conservative Party.
One's voting against the principle, one's got more or less to vote against the means which make the principle possible.
What if your votes help to bring the government down?
I'm afraid that would be the government's fault. I mean, if the government frames its proposals in such a way as to endanger its life, I'm afraid it's the government's to blame, not us.
Will you continue your opposition throughout the enabling legislation?
Yes, I think I will, because it's a matter of principle, and I'm against it in four matters of principle, and I propose to go on. Yeah.
Even though this might put your government at risk?
Well, I think that's for the government to decide whether it wishes to put itself at risk.
Well, I hope the Conservative government won't be so foolish as to get itself in that position, but personally, I'm against going into the common market, and I think that's of more importance than anything else.
Will you continue to vote against the market throughout the enabling legislation?
Having voted on a principle, I don't see how one can then go madly ahead and try to negative one's vote by voting for the legislation which would bring in the principle. No, it's impossible.
Can you see circumstances where, in fact, you will continue your opposition throughout the enabling legislation?
Oh, certainly.
If you decided on one particular clause that you could not support it, that you felt that you would have to vote against the government, and you knew that in so doing this would put the government at risk, would you still vote against the government?
If I felt passionately that it was harming the country to accept that clause, then naturally my answer must be yes.
That you would put the Conservative government at risk?
I would put the country first.
What do you think is the significance of the people who are thinking like yourself at this moment?
Well, that unwittingly, and we're not happy or proud to be in this position, but we seem to hold the fate of this government in our hands.
Will you continue your opposition throughout the enabling legislation?
I never decide how I'm going to vote on legislation till I've seen the legislation, but my feeling is that it's illogical to vote against the principle of something and then support legislation.
I obviously want to see the present government remain in office. I also have the very strong feeling that the Treaty of Rome is against the interests of this country, and I must wait and see on the precise details and then act accordingly.
But on balance, would you put country before party?
Oh, certainly.
You look back at Mr. Heath's guidance, which he gave MPs, Labour MPs, who are going to vote in favour. He said, after you voted in favour, the logic is that you should continue to support the legislation. So the other side of that same coin is clearly that anybody who opposes should logically, according to Mr. Heath, continue to oppose.
My opposition is based upon a number of principles, and I can't possibly vote against my principles. I don't think anyone would expect me to do so. We're going to fight this. We shall argue it out. We shall do our utmost to expose the fallacies, the dangers and the pitfalls, and we shall do this night after night. for as long as is necessary. And in that time, I think public opinion will be alerted to what this common market venture is all about, a tremendous surrender of self-government.